Hello guys and gals, it's me, Mojo Daddy Mystic, back with my main man, Uncle Ted, and we're gonna get into some ink spots with the song, I Don't Wanna Set the World on Fire.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Have you heard of this
song? I heard the song, man.
All right.
I never heard about it, but yeah.
So this was a little bit before Uncle Ted's time.
Yeah. Yeah.
He tells me that this was my grandfather's music.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's a bus move back in the day.
And the Ink Spots played a large role in pioneering the black vocal group harmony genre,
mm-hmm.
helping to pave the way for the doo-wop explosion of the 50s.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to say shout out to the 50s, man, because the doo-wops was mm-hmm. everywhere on the street
yes,
corners,
yes,
man.
Yes, yes, yes.
From George Clinton, he started in, yeah. in a doo-wop group.
Yeah.
To you know all the legends that we know today,
yes,
they got their start in doo-wop groups.
Billy Paul, Jerry
Butler, Little Richard, right?
Yes, sir, Little Richard. A lot of them. Some of them I can't name, man.
Yeah,
yeah.
But they started the doo-wop explosion of the '50s. The quavering high tenor of Bill Kenny, pre-staged hundreds of street corner leads to come.
Go ahead.
The sweet harmonies of Charlie Fuqua, Deke Watson, and bass of Hoppy Jones.
Go ahead.
Backed him flawlessly. Kenny's impeccable diction of Jones' deep drawl were both prominent on the Ink Spots' first smash on Decca in 1939.
Yeah, but that's a long time ago. My parents were babies. Yeah, man.
The seminal If I Didn't Care, from then through 1951, the group's was seldom absent from the pop charts, mm-hmm. topping the lifts mm-hmm. with We Three, My Echo, My Shadow, and Me, mm-hmm. and I'm making believe into Each Life Some Rain Must Fall,
mm-hmm.
both in 1944, and mm-hmm. The Gypsy to Each His Own, both in 1946.
Wow, I didn't even know.
Watson eventually split from his own group, both Brown Dots, and appeared in numerous low-budget film musicals while Kenny attempted a solo career, notching a solo hit in 1951 with the uplifting It's No Secret.
Mm.
Countless, and I think the Jefferson Airplane covered that one.
Oh, okay.
Countless groups masquerading as the Ink Spots mm-hmm. have thrived across the nation since the 1950s.
Because somebody copy, you know you got something bad.
Yeah, nothing beats the original, man.
Yeah, no,
a lot of copycats,
yes,
right?
Sir. Yes, sir.
So we're going to listen to the originals here with the Ink Spots' I Don't Want to Set the World on Fire. Mm-hmm. Brother, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's listen.
Let's go down memory lane.
Let's take a stroll down memory lane.
Yes, sir.
Set your mind back.
Yeah,
let's take a time travel capsule to the mid-50s.
Yeah, processes.
I think the 40s, right?
Yeah, processes and sequence suits.
See where we have come.
Yeah.
Let's vibe to the Ink Spots, man.
Yeah. This is definitely old school.
I don't want to set the world on fire. A flame in your heart.
This is like sitting around the fire.
In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do.
Such class.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
That was a setup for a girl.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to stop a great big flame down in your heart. You see, way down inside of me,
you didn't need a wingman.
Darling, I have only one desire.
This was the wingman.
And that one desire is you. And I know nobody else ain't gonna do. I've lost all ambition or worldly acclaim. I just wanna be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same. I'll have reached
my granddaddy's
mind reading on. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
All right.
See, love me transcends time.
Transcends time.
And you're going to speak the language.
And the era. Folk.
Yeah.
This is a song that's understood today.
Yeah.
The 2000s, right. The 90s, right. 80s, 70s, 60s, 50s, all the way back to the 40s, man.
And the lyrics were passionate and clean.
Yes. Yes.
Notice, clean.
Very understandable.
Clean.
And clean. Right.
Clean.
No derogatory.
Yeah, there we go. No misogynistic nothing.
Right. And you know, we just want to honor that type
yes,
of music.
Yes.
And the men,
yes.
the men.
Yeah.
Let me say. Let me rephrase that.
Yeah.
Let me say it again. The men.
Yeah.
This is real men's.
Yeah. Music, real men speaking to women. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yes, sir.
Whispering.
Yeah.
Softly.
Yeah.
Said, baby.
Yeah. Yeah. Might have been Barry White's great great granddad.
There you go.
I used to think like Barry and Isaac Hayes. Yeah,
yes, but that's where they get
yes,
it from.
Yes, sir.
Man. So we want to highlight that.
Yeah.
And we appreciate that.
Yeah.
Rightfully so, they were inducted in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Yes, sir.
Back in the early 90s.
Yes, sir.
So I'm just so happy about that.
Yeah.
I love the Ink Spot, so. All respect.
Yes,
And we'll see you on the next one, man.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right.
I'll tell you. Oh,
don't leave me hanging.
Not at all. Fuck that. It was the water.
Yes. The music got you.
Yes, sir.